Alright, get ready to go, maybe.
There's the unforgettable sound of sleep apnea. If you or a loved one has sleep apnea, you can help advance research on this potentially life-threatening condition.
Fuck. Hold on. Maps.
People just like you to prevent and better treat sleep apnea. Answering simple questions can make a big impact in discovering new ways to treat and perhaps
starting route to 588 Shingleridge Road.
LionApnea.org is the largest network.
Head east on West Galbraith Road.
Head east, it says. I don't know what the fuck that means. Left or right, goddammit. East. I got my compass.
To help you regain control of your sleep, all in a safe and private online environment. Fill out the online survey and wake up to a better future at myapnea.org.
East is right.
In half a mile, turn right onto Coleraine Avenue.
Oh no! No, I don't want to go this way. This isn't the way it showed me on the map, and now it's taking me this way. Through the ghetto. On I-75, where it's worse than driving in Dubai. Strap in.
This YouTube video, YouTube channel, on which someone thought to be Nicholas Cruz had said that he wanted to be a professional school shooter. Now we hear about a tip that was received by the
turn
FBI
right onto Coleraine Avenue.
You're a fucking dumb shit.
That it was very specific.
Hey, look at that.
Nicholas Cruz. It talked about his mental instability, about the gun that he owned.
It's the same car as mine.
To shoot up a school. And yet the tip was not forwarded on from the tip line to the field office in Miami.
He took his hubcaps off. His looks better than mine. I guess I'll take all the other three off of mine.
In 4.7 miles, keep left to merge onto I-74 east toward I-75.
Yep. I know the way.
Is there any information on how many of these tips, and I'm not defending, I mean, they screwed it up, but how many tips do they, any idea on a daily basis, how many tips like this are given to the FBI?
Yeah, I have no idea, but at the same time, you know, why else have a tip line? Why would you establish a tip line if you didn't
what happened here is it tore down something.
To prevent this kind of thing.
Wow.
Put somebody on the radar of the FBI or other law enforcement officials.
Funny, it's a block away from my house, and I've never noticed that they tore it down. Oh well.
And so somehow this just didn't make it to the field office in Miami.
You know what? For this one, that obviously played out and in this horrific way, yeah. That it actually happened. There were probably, Ed, in the month of January, there were probably 10,000 other tips.
That's what I'm wondering.
That didn't actually materialize into anything. And unfortunately, this one ends up becoming. But I know what you're saying, Jim. You're saying, well, had they just, you know, just knocked on his door, and at least he might have been like, oh, geez, they're watching me. I probably can't. And it could have been thwarted, I suppose.
Yeah, well, maybe. I'm not sure it would have mattered to him. I mean, considering his behavior after the shooting yesterday on Wednesday, leaving the school and then going to a subway and getting a drink and kind of goofing around for a while, it's not as though he seemed particularly concerned about getting caught or not getting caught.
You know what, Jim? And I've been reading about this, and I don't think I've ever gotten the story straight as to actually how they did identify the guy. I've read they escaped that way, and he goes to the subway and gets a lemonade or whatever the heck he did.
Yeah.
And so how did he get identified?
Well, I suspect that either some of the kids there in the school recognized him, although at 19 years old, he might not know many of the kids who were in that part of the, on the campus. He went into Building 1200, which is, I'm told, the freshman section of the school. So most kids probably didn't know who he was, but some of the teachers probably did. Some of the administrators, someone, in fact, a school employee out in the parking lot saw this person who had stepped out of an Uber, by the way, carrying a big duffel bag and a backpack, and was very concerned. Neither that employee recognized that this was Nicholas Cruz, or saw that here's a 19-year-old, and an old-looking kid, carrying all this stuff into school right at the end of the school day. And certainly alarms went up at that point. That literally, the school was put on lockdown at that point, but it was too late.
Is there any word? Are they, do you know if they're going to pursue death penalty? Have they even started talking about that?
They haven't. And they have not.
Is that an option in Florida? I'm going to ask you that.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I mean, they have the death penalty nearby. I mean, I think there are so many steps in front of that before that decision is made. And it sounds as though the defense may be trying to set up an insanity plea or say that he is too mentally unstable to go on trial at all. So, I mean, we're a long way from any sort of courtroom activity beyond these initial appearances.
And with that, Jim Ryan, we'll let you go. Thanks so much, Matt.
Yeah, thanks.
Thanks, Eric.
Now we got trying to get weather together. Bruce, what's going on out there?
And actually, it's a pretty decent Friday afternoon from the UC Health Traffic Center.
So you have Gage, and I know this isn't fair, but I can see about a mile of interstate out of our window on 71. And if it's backed up here, I guarantee you that the interstates are backed up everywhere.
Yeah, but you're looking out at pretty decent traffic, actually, for 71.
Don't look back.
There's a little bit of a broken down shoulder at the Montgomery Ramp where it comes into the interstate at Kenwood, but otherwise, Dana up past the lateral where there was an earlier accident, that's still a little bit slow. And then it's off and on up past Reagan. Southbound, it's from Dana into the downtown. That's much slower. 75 south at Lockland, and then from around Desert Charles through to Kyles. Kyles to the bridge still off and on slow. 75 north, pretty sticky between Mitchell and Paddock, and then through Shepherd, and then off and on up to Union Center. And on the top, beginning to get a little bit heavy, south 275 between Montgomery and Loveland, Madeira. Your next traffic update in 10 minutes. Number Stavis on News Radio 700 WLW.
The forecast from the 700 WLW Weather Center for tonight: clouds, 28 for tomorrow. Rain and snow mixed are possible, and a high of 40, 37 now. News Radio 700 WLW. Before the end of the show, your Chicago and REO tickets for Riverbend come August. We'll give those to you, but listen up for that. In the meantime, Mark Blazer's with me in place of Rock today. And coming up here at the top of the hour, Blaze, Rock and I did this a couple of weeks ago, and I thought it would be a good thing to bring back, is brushes with greatness kind of thing. You've been in radio, not as long as me, but you and I, you come from the same stock. We, you know, been doing the same thing. You did morning radio forever.
Yeah.
So you run across, you meet people in the entertainment business and that type of thing, and politicians and whatever. And I just like to get people's feedback, because we've been shooting a lot of movies here. So, you know, Zac Efron's in town, Lily Collins, who's, in case you didn't know, is Phil Collins' daughter. And she's here shooting that movie, but we've had Bruce Willis in town several times, that type of thing, blah, blah, blah. Have you run across any of these people and your experiences with them?
When I worked at the casino up in Columbus, I used to be a dealer there at Hollywood, and the Bacon Brothers came in to perform. So Kevin Bacon is walking around downstairs, like where we all take our breaks or whatever. He goes walking by, and it's like, is that Kevin Bacon? I mean, that guy has the most glorious hair, by the way. I have to just throw that.
Dude's got a, he's got a glass for him.
Dude, you know, you see, for instance, like, I don't know if you've seen Schwarzenegger in person, but you see people that have a lot of money, like him or like Kevin. Their skin, John Bon Jovi's one, when I was backstage, their skin has this glow. They reek of money. I mean, they just look like
they reek of money.
Kevin was one of those guys.
I don't know if he's chapstick. These guys got some woman who's rubbing whatever, you know, elephant testicle meat into their faces to make them look better. I don't even know where that comes from, but all these people coming through town, or somewhere if you're in an airport, I don't care,
I was Hawaiian Terrace. It's the deadliest street in Cincinnati right now. Drive down there, you're guaranteed to get shot six times.
He came in, he was shooting a movie in Granville, up near...
Because they were supposed to shoot that movie, the car movie, and they ended up shooting up there.
Yeah, so he was in town shooting that. He comes in there, he ended up winning $250,000 while he was in there, by the way.
Say, why not?
Playing dice, I'm not kidding. He won $250,000, he tipped the dealers, us, like $5,000. The guy that was shooting, he throwing dice for like 35 minutes, he threw him a grand. No kidding. He was right in the middle of the table, in the middle of the regular floor. Had two guys with him who were, I think they were his bodyguards or whatever. But he's mixing it up with everybody. People are
you know, yippee-ki-yay, mother, you know, like, right, doing all kinds, and he's high-fiving people, just having a good old time. Yeah, he won like $250,000 when he was there. Nicest guy ever, completely nice to everybody, just, you know, like, ah, good Christmas, they say it's, you know, like, he's doing quotes from Die Hard, and, you know.
That's awesome.
I know, really good time with him. So I have great stories about him and Kevin Bacon's really good stories.
Seeing that, Kevin Bacon, and you and I but people always think being radio voice.
In 1 mile, keep left to merge onto I-74 East toward I-75.
Yep, I know. I really only need you for the end part. But I'll keep it going. Hopefully the battery is going to hold up because I need you on the way back. Well, no, I don't, I guess. No, I don't need it on the way back. Just the way out there. And only at the end. Nope. I need it up here a little bit, too.
Uh-oh.
Oh, it's a shirt. Okay, it's now a copy. Good, good. Amen. That's my old street.
He was going to be on the show. And it's one of those things where the, where you're talking on your phone and you don't think.
When I lived there, that's the last time I had the kids over. This is when I lived on Amen. This is North Side, by the way. It's kind of scary to live here, but it's.
Use the left 2 lanes to keep left to merge onto I-74 East toward I-75.
I will.
And
as soon as I'm allowed to go.
Alright, so I'm whatever. Play okay, here's Metallica. So I throw the interview aside. So the phone's still on off the air, and I'm dropping multiple F-bombs. They're like a that guy, blah, 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 blah.
He thought he hung up or whatever.
I can't believe he's not. Oh, I can't believe he stiffed us. That is bull. And so my producer goes,
I hear sirens. But I can't see where it's coming from, so it's time to drive. Try to get away from it.
Keep left.
I know.
Something was screwed up on their end. He was trying to talk to us, but we couldn't hear him. So eventually, my producer talked to us for a quick one time. He is very sorry. He's so mad because it sounded like, there you go. It sounded like that was just very angry. So I bring out with Nikki Six for a second interview with him, and he looked exactly the same. And at this point, he actually read The Hero of Diamonds, his book is from.
Yeah.
Use the right 2 lanes to keep right toward I-75 South and US 52 East.
Got it.
Keep right. Traffic for here. There's a couple idiots up there being stupid, but nothing too bad. I'm gonna stay right behind Mr. J.B. Hunt because he knows the way. Do you know the way? Oh, where are you going, man? I thought we were gonna stick together. Oh well. Guess I'll go on without you.
Say goodbye to expensive blue pills with side effects. Gainsway lets you be spontaneous. What you want? when you want it. When Speedway you want it.
In 2 miles, exit left onto I-71 North and US 50 East toward I-471.
Yep. Ah, fuck, here's the traffic.
And it's pain-free. Gainswave is a revolutionary 20-minute erectile dysfunction treatment available now at Huber Personalized Medicine.
Here's the traffic. We found it.
Call Huber Personalized Medicine at 513-924-5300. That's 513.
Wow, there's coyotes this far into the city.
Or visit Gainswave.
There's a squish coyote back there. They're everywhere now.
Gainswave and other enhancement
they're going to be as bad as raccoons soon. Well, maybe better yet, maybe they'll eat all the raccoons. That would be great. Because raccoons are terrifying. Coyotes aren't really terrifying. They just look like, you know, little brown dogs. All right. Yeah. Oh, there's an idiot. Fontaine County. I have no idea where this guy's from. Let's get a little closer so I can read that license plate. But not too close.
Learning more about what happened in the days leading up to Wednesday in Parkland, Florida. This is continuing coverage from News Radio.
Oh, shit.
With the 5 o'clock report. I'm Jack.
I'm going to catch him.
Broward County, Florida Sheriff Scott Israel giving an update on Wednesday.
Michigan. Okay. Makes sense. 75 runs all the way up to Michigan.
Use the left two lanes to exit left onto I-71 North and US 50 East toward I-471.
Got it. Glad I'm not going that other way. Look at that shit. That's to go into Kentucky.
Exit left, then keep right.
Keep right. Oh. Okay, well.
Use the left lane to keep right. Use the left lane to keep left to merge onto I-71 North toward I-471.
Okay, then it's just tell me to, I don't know, I guess. This one, right? Yeah, this is the way. This is the way. Right? Yeah, I got it. That's where it's tricky. Stupid shit. Oh, yeah, there's the football stadium. That's where the Bengals play. It's a piece of shit. We're going to go by where the Reds play, too. I don't know if you'll be able to see it. Right in the middle in between them is where the Cyclones play.
Stay in the second lane from left.
Second lane
from left. In 3/4 of a mile, take the exit to merge onto I-471 south toward Newport, KY.
Got it. I'm in the right lane by accident. I'm busy talking instead of paying attention. Yeah, you don't get to see it, but we are right next to the Reds stadium. Oh, wait, no, that's right there, U.S. Bank Arena. That's where the Cyclones play. So you did get to see that.
Use the right two lanes to take the exit to merge onto I-471 south toward Newport, KY.
Yeah, I know. Just got to deal with these stupid fucks getting on here because some of them don't. Oh, man, that was a big asshole.
Take the exit.
I'm gonna take the exit. Is that alright? You see, this is tricky. Take it at high speed. More people trying to get where they don't. Okay. Come on, guys. Get your shit together.
Take exit 1A on the left to merge onto I-275 East toward Columbus, Ohio.
Yeah, I know. That's a long way away, though. No guarantees I'll survive it. Here's the traffic, and I'm so happy to be a part of it. I'm ecstatic. Just so, so excited. I need to get over. What are you doing, you goofy twat? Oh my God, what are you doing? Fucking sit in our blind spot. Great. I'm just gonna have to push people out of the way. I'm gonna have to start driving like they do, I guess. Like a dick. Okay, I'm coming over. Get out of the way. Thank you. Yeah, good for you, buddy.
Exit 1A on the left to merge onto I-275 East toward Columbus, Ohio.
Got it. Already there. Pissing everybody off.